In this video, we will give a brief explanation of how we derive the energy balance for a plug flow reactor. And we'll do this for a simple system, just A goes to B type reaction to make it easier to see where the equations come from. And what we're going to do, and this is an expanded view, we're looking at a plug flow reactor, and we're going to look at a small slice, which, of course, relative to the diameter of the reactor, this slice would be minuscule, and I've just expanded it to make it easier to visualize. And we have material flowing in at this point at a molar flow rate of reactant, FA, and temperature T, and then material leaving this small differential slice, where the flow rate of A has changed by a differential amount. If it's a reactant, it's decreased and the DFA is negative. And the temperature has also changed by a differential amount. Reaction has taken place within this volume. And then we would have heat transfer through the walls, rate of heat transfer. And what we want to look at is an energy balance. The general form, we have some accumulation of energy in the system due to flow in, flow out, and the fact we add heat. Now we're going to look at a steady state system. So we'll derive for a steady state plug flow reactor, so accumulation is zero. And so into this differential volume, we're flowing A and B. A has an enthalpy per mole evaluated at this temperature coming into the reactor, and then same form for B. So A and B are both flowing in. So that's this term, flow in. We then have flow terms out, where we said the flow rate of A has changed and the enthalpy of A has changed. So let's write this first like so. And then I wrote the same term for B. And then we have the energy added by heat transfer. So what we're going to do is divide this equation by differential volume. And I'm going to simplify. Now, before I do that, let's point out that in the simplification, notice I have flow rate of A. And then I have flow rate of A, enthalpy out with the negative sign. So those terms are going to cancel, likewise for flow rate of B. So it's going to simplify quite a bit because of that. So here is the equation that's simplified. And I think I left out, let's make sure we have the signs right. So remember this term disappeared, it canceled with this term. So we have four terms from here, and one of them canceled, and we end up with the remaining three. Now, we're going to simplify this further because we're looking at a differential volume, differential changes. So these are derivatives, but notice this derivative is multiplied by still a differential term. So this is going to go to zero, and that's going to simplify the equation. We're going to now simplify it a couple other ways. One, we see we have the change in flow rate of A respect to volume, which is from our mass balance minus R, where, for example, R might be KCA for first order reaction. And the derivative of the flow rate of B respect to volume is plus R, because we're forming product R. And the enthalpy of B at a temperature minus the enthalpy of A at the same temperature, that's the heat of reaction at that temperature. And then we need one more term, and that's that the derivative of enthalpy given temperature respect to volume is equal to the heat capacity, that component, derivative of temperature with respect to volume. So we can make these substitutions into our equation up here and simplify further. And so the energy balance in for a plug flow reactor simplifies to this. And of course, we would be solving this simultaneously with the mass balance for the reactor. So one term that we might want to look at in a little more detail is this heat transfer across the wall. So we could go back and look at the diagram. This differential volume would correspond to some distance dz down the reactor. And of course, this tube has a diameter d. So if we look at heat transfer, we'd have circumference times dz. So this is the area for heat transfer. We have some overall heat transfer coefficient. We have some temperature. Let's call it a cooling temperature. If this temperature is lower than reactor temperature, removing heat, this term is negative. If it's higher, we're adding heat. And you know, in the energy balance, we have dq dv, which is the volume pi d squared over 4 times dz. So the term dq dv is 4u over d. U is the heat transfer coefficient, d is the diameter, t external cooling. And so, in general, this is the heat transfer area per volume. Now, sometimes we'll end up writing the energy balance in terms of mass heat capacities, and a volumetric flow rate times the density is a mass flow rate, and then a mass heat capacity on the left side, and the right side is the same form as here, 4u over d, tc minus t. And so we can certainly look at more complicated forms. If we have more than one reaction, of course, we'd have an additional term for the second reaction. But this gives us an overview of where the energy balance comes from in terms of enthalpy calculations.